Welcome to Well's Quick Tips and Tricks cooking channel. Today I'm come up with a Goan dish once again, which I'm going to have it for my lunch, and that is called Tambri Bhaji. I went to market in today. Market means like just outside they sit, and I found this from a Goan lady, fresh. So I'm going to make tambri bhaji in Goan style, and for that we need, I've got two bunches of this. I will be finally chopping it, and then I need 4 to 5 cloves of crushed garlic, which I have crushed on this stone. 1 green chili this way. 1 onion this way chopped, and 1 tomato. And I'll be using coconut oil, which I purchased at Nanu's farm in Cape, where I had gone to hunt some quails. That video will be coming soon. And so it's like a pure coconut they are selling. They are a farm where they sell many things over there. And I purchased many of the spices too over there, because it is like fully organic. And I was happy with the price also. This was like 500 ml, 175 rupees, and it is organic. And I saw the farm, and it's a beautiful farm, and I'll be visiting it again, because of lockdown I could not enter the farm, but they had put a stall outside and they were selling lot of things like pure kokum and different types of Goan spices like solna, that is kokum, and ginger, dry ginger, wet ginger, and I found there that is called Niro of coconut. They were selling toddy also, and they were selling Niro also, which I made sanna, which was an awesome experience. And I took some peppers and cloves, so it was like nice small shopping there. And farm is also very big, and in Cape they have got plenty other farms too. Many farms are there, but I visited this farm because it was attractive, greenery and nice. Okay, so I'll be using this coconut oil to fry my onion and all this. Then I have taken around 1 tablespoon each of masoor dal, 1 tablespoon, 1 tablespoon of moong dal, and 1 tablespoon of chana dal. So I soaked it for around 30 minutes. And either you can fry this separately and add it, or you can directly add it when you are cooking the vegetable. It's up to your choice. Both taste awesome. And this is ginger garlic paste I will be adding to it. And the dry spices which I am going to add are 1 teaspoon of cumin powder, 1 teaspoon of turmeric powder, and 1 teaspoon of chili powder, and 1 teaspoon of coriander powder, and mustard seeds 1 teaspoon, and 1 teaspoon of cumin seed, salt to taste. So let's start. So first let us take oil. So here goes Nanu's Farm's pure coconut oil. So I am taking around 1 big tablespoon of coconut oil. And in that I will add my cumin seeds and mustard seeds. So here comes cumin seeds. And mustard seeds. Till then I will chop my spinach too. This red spinach, that is tambri bhaji, is one of my favorite. I can just eat rice and this tambri bhaji. I don't need anything else. But then yes, fish is there side by, or some salt fish, then also it is nice. Here goes my onion. And you know how you come to know that it is pure coconut oil? It doesn't rot. If in any coconut oil, if there is any mixture, then the oil will rot. So when you add this and when you add all the ingredients and it doesn't rot, that means it's a pure coconut oil. And I'm happy about this, that I found it in Nanu's organic farm in Cape. We do get it in Maxa market also, but then it's like, if you are lucky enough, then you will get it a good one. Sorry, my light is gone. Today the power cut is too much over here. On and off, on and off. So I added my onion, now my chilies and my tomato. So this thing, let it get nicely soft. This is a quick vegetable. No adding of water, because tambri bhaji needs its water on own. Those days there was adao. Now also there is adao, but due to time and sitting, I also have adao. I do have adao and I use sometimes. Especially cutting fish on adao is a different experience. It was, I think, so made for all of us women, like if we get tired and it's a long procedure work. You've won my heart. Here it is. And my grandma used to cut it so finely on that adao. So you can finely chop, or you can chop it how you want. Choice is yours. So it's a nice aroma I am getting of my coconut oil. So please, if you are anytime in Goa or anywhere, if you are in north, then visit this farm and get your spices. So here I go, 1 teaspoon of coriander powder, 1 teaspoon of cumin powder, 1 teaspoon of turmeric powder, and I'm adding little bit of chili powder, very little I'm adding, because my green chili is there. And fry this nicely. and we'll add
our dal pe
maiso
dals, three dals.
Here it goes. And I'm adding my ginger garlic paste now. 1 teaspoon. You can fry ginger garlic at the start, but I love the flavor of ginger garlic. So let it get nicely cooked. And I will add my salt to this. Salt to taste again. Mix the salt. And my crushed garlic also will go now. So again, if you want to fry, you can fry it when you are frying mustard. But I want to give my spinach the flavor of garlic, then again ginger garlic paste. And now we will add our tamari bhaji to this, which I have chopped it. So here goes my tamari bhaji. So I'm not mixing this anything, I'm just stirring it. And I will cook this. So I'm covering this and let it get cook. No adding water, as it will leave its own water. So it will take around 15 to 20 minutes to get cooked, because there is dal is there. And if you don't add any dal, then it will take around 5 to 7 minutes to get it cooked. Because tamari bhaji doesn't take much time, doesn't consume much time. So let us now mix this. It's nicely leaving the water. I mean, mix this and leave this too. Get it cook on a slow fire. Another 10 to 15 minutes and my tamari bhaji is ready. So I will garnish it with some curry leaves on top. Again, I want the curry leaves to eat it that way, because curry leaves, that is curry patta, is also very healthy. So thank you.